Hey guys, welcome back to another lazy lesson by Insights. Today we'll discuss about state legislative councils, their creation, composition, need, criticisms, and ways to make them more effective. We also have a fact for the day, that is Mount Kilimanjaro. First of all, let us understand how a legislative council is created. Here, please note that the Constitution of India has the provision of establishing bicameral legislatures in more populous states. However, for states, having a second house is not by force but by choice. Under Article 169 of the Constitution, Parliament may by law create or abolish the second chamber in the state if the legislative assembly of that state passes a resolution to that effect by a special majority. Here, special majority means majority of the strength of the house and 2/3 majority of the present and voting, that is absolute plus special majority. Now, as per Article 171, Clause 1 of the Constitution, the total number of members in the Legislative Council of a state shall not exceed 1/3 of the total number of the members in the Legislative Assembly, and at the same time, the strength cannot be less than 40. Now, out of the total members, 1/3 members are elected by the members of the assembly, that is MLAs. Another 1/3 by electorates consisting of members from municipalities, district boards and local authorities in the state. Another 1/12 is elected by an electorate consisting of teachers. Last 1/12 by registered graduates. The remaining members are nominated by the governor from various backgrounds, including literature, science, art, cooperative movement and social service. Why do we need a second house? It is because a second house acts as a check on hasty actions by the legislative assembly. It also helps in sharing of work. It allows for more debate. Besides, it widens the space for representative democracy. It also serves as a forum for academicians and intellectuals to contribute to the legislative process. Finally, it provides a mechanism for a more serious appraisal of legislation. However, there are few arguments against having a second house. First of all, the Constituent Assembly itself was divided over the issue. K.T. Shah, a member, was firmly against having a bicameral legislature for states. He called the Legislative Council as a reactionary and non-elected body which could end up deflecting the legislative machinery. He called those who want a second chamber as the champions of vested interests. The second criticism is that if there was a real benefit in having a second house, why don't all the states have it? These legislative councils can be used to accommodate party functionaries who fail to get elected. To be precise, it has become a haven for losers in elections. It is also an unnecessary drain on the exchequer. Besides, no substantial powers are given to legislative councils. Let us take this point in detail. Here, unlike Rajya Sabha, which has substantial powers to shape non-financial legislation, legislative councils lack the constitutional mandate to do so. It is because legislative assemblies have the power to override suggestions or amendments made to a legislation by the council. Second, while Rajya Sabha MPs can vote in the election of the president and vice president, members of legislative councils cannot. MLCs also can't vote in the elections of Rajya Sabha members. With respect to money bills, only 14 days delay can be caused by the council, which is more or less a formality rather than a barrier. Hence, they can only delay progressive legislations. Now, what can be done? We need a comprehensive national policy on having upper house in state legislatures. Besides, recommendations of committees like second ERC need to be implemented. Also, more say should be given to local bodies. This will help strengthen the root level democracy. Today's fact for the day. We have Mount Kilimanjaro. It is a dormant volcano in Tanzania. It is the highest mountain in Africa. You can see the location of the summit here. It was in news recently because a physically challenged man from Kerala has conquered this mountain on crutches. Now, where is it located? It is just below the Horn of Africa, surrounded by Zambia, Mozambique, Somalia, Kenya, and other countries. Today's homework: find out how many states have legislative councils as of today.